example, it's easy. When you want to make a fourfold chain, you obviously need to achieve it, right? So you're going to need those nucleosides to provide ATP so that you can generate the process easily by using hydrolysis. So you can have an extension of the DNA. So this is a function of the molecule. It's just a graph. It depicts the three stages that she alluded, which is denaturation, annealing primers, and exhaling primers. But I want to put more emphasis on what's really going on. So you've got DNA, which is denatured. It means it's breaking all the hydrogen bonds. So it's exposed to the free floating nucleotides on the solution, meaning that those nucleotides can take advantage of those exposed strands. Remember what helicase do? It breaks the double-stranded DNA. And then you've got what are called single-stranded binding proteins. Do you remember that? So what they do, they stabilize those bonds so that you don't have any attraction of the double strand. The primers, as we know, they're going to synthesize. They're going to do a direct copy of the original DNA strand. Subsequently, you're going to have an extension of the prepared DNA. So this has to be maintained, it has to be kept in a prepared environment so that you don't tamper with the requirement. For example, the buffer, a couple of the monovalent ions and univalent ions. So you want to keep the same, everything on the same page. Okay, this is the end product of amplification. So having chosen a specific segment of DNA, you want it to expand or to increase exponentially. This is what is happening. You have the first stage, which is different from the second stage, the first stage, which is different from the second stage. So this happens three times. This is in vitro, it's in the laboratory. We have it to get ahead of it being applied in the molecular environment, in the human. So, lastly, this is the guy that discovered the mystery. It's called K-Viris. He's still alive, you can check on him. Thank you.